Grr, I say, snarly teeth. Hello everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough. It looks like I'm gonna have to duel her before I can get a little further here. So let's do so. By the way, to do this little walking animation thing here when you're standing still, what you do is when you push into a square, automatically push towards a wall, and you'll automatically do that little walking thing. I don't know if it's a glitch or not, but it happens. It doesn't work if you're not pushing up against a wall or a person or something like that, when you transition between squares like that, but it always works when you're pushing up against the wall, like so. See that? Yeah, it's kind of weird. But anyway, let's do this. Let's duel and dance. Doesn't it feel good to relax by the pool? Isn't it wonderful to duel in a place like this? Yeah, I guess. Okay, I'll play with three prizes. It'll be a one-match duel. Although I wouldn't want my water cards to fall in the water. That would be pretty devastating. So let's duel far, far away from the pool. Oh, I got no basic Pokemon. That's sad. It's kind of funny that I've got a bunch of fire Pokemon. They're still standing up against the water Pokemon assault of this place. It's just that I have very... Oh, three-prize battle, by the way. That's, yeah, it's another short kind of game. Not as short as the last one, though, that I had here. The two-prize thing. That's a... It's kind of a weird card. Yeah, it's like Mysterious Fossil, except you can't evolve it. And she's got Mysterious Fossil, too! she's got nothing else, though. Wow, that's... That might not be good for her. We're gonna see how things go here, because she could very well water gun me into oblivion before I know it. But, uh-oh, Omanyte's out. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, she can see my hand. She knows I'm in trouble, to an extent. Not in that much trouble. Okay, I'll plop that on there. She still doesn't have energy cards, so I'm just gonna use an ember and put that pressure on her. Chances are she's gonna put out Clefairy Doll. Omanyte, really? It only has 40 HP and... she can't really attack. Well, okay. I got Magmar, and I got Growlithe. And I got Fighting Energy. I got Plus Power! And I've got Ember! So, say goodbye to Omanyte. This is gonna be, going pretty quick. I wonder if I should re-duel her, because she's not really having all that much luck. And I'd like to show you more of her deck. I believe she's got Aerodactyl as well, if I'm not mistaken. So she could prevent me from getting evolutions out and stuff and stuff. I think Magmar's gonna end up being more useful than Charmander in the long run. So I'm gonna do that. And just do some little scratch damage. Literally scratch damage. Just... Uh-oh. Uh-oh, I forgot she had that! Oh god, one of the greatest basic Pokemon ever! She can do massive amounts of damage with that Scyther. She can do 60 damage the turn, well, the turn after she puts it out. See, it's got Swords Dance, which increases the power of Slash, which you can power up with any kind of energy card for just 3. So yeah, that's a pretty dangerous little meatball there. I'm just stalling here. Yes. I did that little bit of extra... I mean, I did that evolution because it's gonna give Charmeleon an extra turn. Well, it's gonna give Charmander an extra turn. Now it turned into Charmeleon because it would've gotten knocked out. Oh shoot, why did I do that? Always with the misclicks. Misclicks are my greatest nemesis. Oh, well. I'm doing okay. Just as long as I can prevent her from sweeping me with stuff, I should be good. Okay. Okay, I'll get Arcanine going here. And Smog. Yeah! This is gonna force her to switch. And if she switches into Scyther, she's going to be taking double damage from Magmar. Oh, Poliwag that she's gonna switch you out. I was gonna say she's gonna switch to Poliwag. No, she has it. Okay. That's fine. I can just poison that one too! Actually, I didn't know if I was gonna poison it. I just got lucky there. And now she's gonna need an energy card to switch out Poliwag, otherwise she loses. Which I would very much appreciate she would— aw, oh, she's got potion. She must have just drawn that. She would have probably used a potion on something else, knowing this game's AI. Anyway, it doesn't matter, I still win with my smog.
Oh, yeah!
And now I can duel that gate blocker. Oh, yeah! So, yeah, I guess you kinda are. So she gives mystery booster packs, and she gives, since it's pretty quick to duel her because it only takes 3 prize cards to beat her, this might be your best source for mystery booster packs. I got one of these before, didn't I? I think I did. Always happy to see double colorless energy for future deck builds, though. Persian? Sorta kinda iffy. I'm pretty sure I said that many times before, actually, come to think of it. So I'll just stop talking about Persian in the future. Moltres can be pretty powerful. It's one of those sorts of cards that you can either use to burn your opponent out of cards, or hope to get lucky and do massive amounts of damage with Dive Bomb. But it doesn't have much HP, so just hope that you can dish out the damage with Moltres. It's not terribly bad if you can power it up on the bench, but it is a little energy consumption-ish. Especially since it doesn't have much HP, so you'll lose those energy cards pretty fast if it gets knocked out with its low HP. So it's up to you if you want to use that, if you have some sort of strategy for it. Okay, we're good. Losing kind of destroys the atmosphere of the place. Really? Looks just fine to me. Then again, you're not on the Well, you are on the losing side. What am I saying, anyway? You must be pretty good if you defeated Sarah and Amanda. As promised, I'll test your skills. If you win, I will introduce you to Amy. You bet I would like to duel you. So, he's got the Sound of the Waves deck, and his deck is really, really varied, if I'm not mistaken. So, he's got the sort of deck that's like a cornucopia of It's just automatic. If I see Bill, I automatically play it, even though it's not the first turn of the game yet. But yeah, he's got this deck that's all over the place, if I'm not mistaken. So, it's kind of inconsistent, so you'll eventually win versus it. I don't like that he's going to be using Acid soon, especially since I'm weak against it, but if I get a plus power next turn, I win, unless he's got a bench Pokemon. So, I'm just going to let him use Acid, and yeah, we'll see how things go, I guess. Plus power would be pretty nice. You know what? I'm not thinking enough into the future. I'm just gonna evolve into Arcanine and do that, because chances are I won't get a plus power if I use Professor Oak. So yeah, I'm just gonna do that and call it a turn. Now watch, I would get a plus power if I use Professor Oak. It's just gonna be the game taunting me. Eradicate. What I could do... No, I'm just going to use Professor Oak. I'm overthinking this. I should just be using Professor Oak. And watch. Plus power. No plus power. Interesting. Okay, so I did play that correctly. To an extent. And I win. Okay, I'll give him a rematch like I did Ghost Deck Guy, because he got really, really unlucky here. Before I go and duel Amy. So, yeah. Let's see what I get. Mystery Booster Packs. Hollowed Lapras! Oh, yes! Another awesome basic Pokemon, but I'm gonna have to trade it for, that Arcanine back in the other room. So, yeah. I think I'll do that at the end of this part. But for now, I'm just going Energy Removal for a secondary deck. Awesome-tastic. Oh, yes. Okay. I clicked that little too fast. I'm sorry. Don't think you're that good just because you defeated me. We still have Amy here at the Water Club. Amy, please wake up. Huh? What's going on? I was enjoying my little nap. Well, What? You lost? How could you? Was it Mark? I will be your next opponent. Hi, Amy of the Water... Master of the Water Club. She's like, no, I would like to duel the other guy again, just to give him a shot. So here we go. Rematch of the century. Four prizes. Just so you can see his deck a little bit more in action, how he plays and whatnot. So, seven cards. Hopefully he'll get a little bit more out of this. I still got a kind of a poopy opening hand, even though Magmar is not that poopy. It's just a thing of that it's risky to only have one basic Pokemon out when he could potentially sweep me. You know, with his... because people around here play water. Alright, that Professor Oak will most certainly help. Let's see if I can get something that's not Fire Out. Rattata plus Raticate will be nice, so I'm not going to Professor Oak right away. I just like to get Rattata out first and stall out with Smokescreen, because chances are he's not going to be able to knock out my Magmar. Oh no! Energy removal! Have mercy! Okay. Plus power for the future. For now, though, we got Raticate and attack with Smokescreen. I think what I'll do is plus power just to make sure that I knock out Krabby on the next turn, unless the energy removals me again. No attack, huh? Interesting. Okay. Because I don't know if I'm going to get the coin flip heads for Smog. We'll see. Okay, good. Glad I used plus power. I just wanted to use plus power to take the risk out of it. It would have been kind of a waste if I would have got the coin flip, but who knows if I would have gotten the coin flip. That's the whole thing. And Iron Grip is going to do 40 damage! Ow. Alright, I better get my rap going here. And might as well plus power. And Smog! Yeah. Okay. Okay. So, his Krabby will be knocked out next turn. He's going for the Iron Grip. I guess he wants to go for the double knockout here. Because he knows that Krabby's going down. And what do I get? Super Energy Removal. That's very useful. So let's play it. There we go. Double colorless for my Raticate. I got like the best draws this game ever. Even though I started out with a bad looking hand, it's just that my hand just kept building itself up turn after turn. And yeah. By the way, I didn't really show you Lapras, did I? When I got it in the pack. Water Gun doesn't seem like all that powerful, but in a Rain Dance it's very nice. You know, Rain Dance deck it's very nice. But the Confuse Ray, plus its high HP is what makes this great Pokemon. What makes this Pokemon great? Excuse me, got my words mixed up there. I should probably Professor Oak, if I am wise. Yeah, because chances are, Raticate could be destroyed. I got another Magmar. Okay. Already attached one. Whoops. bite. Let's do it. Let's do it. Do it. What you got? What you got? What you got? Getting Lapras ready, huh? Well. Not gonna get Lapras ready. Okay. And a bite for the win. Okay. And I'll probably Super Fang that Lapras if he puts it out. I'll still Super Fang that Seal, because it's gonna do 30 damage as opposed to the 20 that it would normally do with Bite. I mean, you get what I'm saying here. I'm doing the math in my head. I should probably put up Hitmonchan here, actually, because it's better than having a Fire Pokemon against this Water deck, after all. So I might as well focus on that, as long as I have the opportunity to. If you can't tell right now, tight matchups aren't a necessity. So, as long as you got a good strategy, you should be winning games left and right for the most part. Mm-hmm. And it looks like I win. But. I can't really do much more, can I? Well, I guess I could plop that on there. Oh well. Fight! For the win! Literally, prize card, another Rattata. Give me some more boosters. Okay, so now I guess you got a good idea of how his deck plays out. Mysteries again, of course. Fossil Zapdos. I think you've seen that one before. It's a bench attacking Zapdos, but kind of risky. Okay. It seems like the only cards that I'm getting that are new are rare cards now. You know, the ones with stars. This is great for a Rain Dance deck, Articuno, because you need to power up quickly. And it'll do some very disruptive things. Okay. No, I'm pretty sure it wasn't locked. Now. I'm going to go over here. And... Hi, how's it going? Yes, I did, because I finally got one now. Here we go. Got the trade. Got the Arcanine. Level 34 promotional card. Yeah, I don't think it's as good as the original Arcanine, but, you know, it's a collectible. Sound good? Good. Alright. Thanks, Mark. I'll take good care of this Lapras. Hey, you're the one who gave me your Lapras. What, you forgot about me already? I should say you didn't notice that I didn't walk away from you already? How's that possible? I'll forget about it. I'm taking good care of your Lapras. Good. Good. Keep it in a nice card sleeve. And with that, I'm gonna end out the part here. I hope you enjoy. And I'll see you in the next part when I take on Amy, the Water Master. And also, grrr at you, man, for not letting me in here sooner. Grrr. I'm gonna dance my frustrations away in front of you, and I will make you watch.